I told you I needed it, babes. I'm sorry, I'll sell my soul to you. I'll hit you back in a few, okay? You better be back. I really cannot believe you did this. This is my worst fear, and you did it. There's no reason for you to be afraid of this. The rest of us aren't afraid that's gonna happen. You know why? Because we don't count $3,000 in front of a guy we met on Tinder 3 weeks ago and leave him alone with our $3,000 that we just counted in a cookie jar.
Chad, she had to tweet like that for real. Like, are you dumb? I don't know if she understands the gravity of what she did. And chances are she probably still gonna go back and mess around with this man. Y'all, I really can't. Is my channel, and today we are actually going to be reacting to a court case from the People's Court, and the name of this episode is Tinder Date Dash with the Cash. Now, I'm telling you this right now, this honestly brought me back PTSD from the dating days. I'm so happy that I'm in a loving relationship. P.S. We about to make 2 years this month. We're gonna be taking a beautiful trip to Mexico. Bay flying me out or whatever. And I'm just like, I'm so happy I don't have to be out here in these dating streets because it's crazy. Like, this don't even make any sense. So make sure you comment down below your most wild Tinder dating stories, because I know I definitely hopped on here a long time ago telling the craziest story times about horrible dates I've had that were connected to Tinder or not connected to Tinder. Just the dating world is just a mess. So definitely head down to the description box. I'm going to have my story time playlist linked down below. Also, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe. Just get all the other information that you guys always ask me about in the comment section. And make sure you guys join the Mafia email list. I'll be sending out the videos that I posted on YouTube for the week every week to your inbox, because you know social media lets play with my notifications, especially YouTube. So yeah, without further ado, let's get straight into it.
She met the defendant online and they knew each other for about 3 weeks when he stole her life savings.
I hate to be an asshole, but you met the dude for 3 weeks. You left him alone in your house with your life savings. How he see the life savings?
Oh, child.
Miss me. I want to know what this man looked like, because he just finessed the hell out of her. 3 weeks, left him alone with your life savings. Why is your life savings not in a bank account? Like, what was you doing? Keeping that shit under your mattress? Like,
Was her $2,700 in cash. The cops questioned
him.
He forked over $1,300 of her money. She still owed $1,400 and is suing for just that today. He says he met a plaintiff on Tinder, and when he explained his financial situation to her, she helped him out and gave him $1,800 so we could pay.
First of all, I mean, he is kind of cute, but second of all, you're telling me after 3 weeks of knowing you, you explained your situation, your little life story to her, and she gave you $1,800. Honestly, I find that really hard to believe. I feel like he definitely used his looks to an advantage. But third of all, I also feel like she definitely needs to get it together. Ain't no damn way you're telling me this man played you this hard that you gave him $1,800 that quick, or that he stole that much money from you that fast. And even if it was only $1,800, where the rest? 1 + 1 is not 28. Where's the rest of the money, bruh?
And call the cops on him, claiming he stole the money. This woman's a liar. He stole nothing from her and owes nothing. He accused of theft.
I'm sorry. The narrator's voice is just so fucking hilarious. Like, it's just, oh Lord. Like, oh, they need to do something about this. I'm so shocked after all these years they have not changed it.
Taya Stryker. And who's the person with you?
My mother.
All right. How old are you?
Mom, daughter look exactly the same. They look like twins. Lord Jesus, spitting image. I thought I looked like my mom. This right here, they look like they are like identical twins.
You met on Tinder, and then you were dating him for,
we call it dating
or not really?
I wouldn't call it dating. Okay. I would call it just seeing each other for about 2 weeks beforehand.
For 2 weeks.
So, went on to go get food by myself, left him in my room, and beforehand he had seen where I kept my cash and everything like that.
Oh my God, are you dumb?
she's old enough to know better. I don't know if she don't got street smart. I don't know if she don't got common sense. But why, sis? Oh my God, bitch. Now listen, if this was my friend, if this was my sister, if this was my mom, I would have said the same thing, okay? Don't think I'm just going in on this girl because it's the internet and I'm just popping shit. Trust me, I talk like this to everybody. This is really, really stupid. Why in the hell would you let somebody that you don't even know like that see where you put your money? Thousands of dollars at that. Your life savings at that. First of all, that should have been in a bank. Second of all, if you're going to have it out, you don't let anyone see where you store it, especially not some man that you don't even know like that. And the fact that he's like sitting here smirking in court, he's not even taking this shit serious, and she doesn't even look mad at him. Like, if someone stole $2,700 from me, I'd be pretty damn furious. I don't care how much money I have in life. $2,700, bitch, it's mine.
I'm 20 years old.
Okay, so you've been saving this money for 4 years.
Yes.
And so what you do is counted in front of a guy you met in Tinder 3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I know. I come back, he's gone, money's gone.
How much money was gone?
It was exactly $2,700.
How do you know?
Because we had counted it earlier that day.
The girl! I'm not playing with this girl, bro. I'm not. You meet a guy on Tinder, you only know him for about 3 weeks or less. You literally take out your life savings and you start counting it with him, in which you let him see where you store the money afterwards, and now he takes the money and he dips off. I can't feel sorry for you at that point because you're stupid. And then the mom's sitting here, I'm green done. There's nothing funny about this shit. Women that let men take advantage of them to this type of gravity usually have a self-esteem issue. You usually feel somewhat threatened or are just plain like clueless and ignorant when it comes to street smart. So I don't know which one it is, but I'm very sure by the end of the video we're gonna figure out what it is.
Did you take her money?
Yes.
I'm not gonna lie, like we were talking about the whole like money situation, and like, you know, like I need to pay child support and like my fines and stuff, and like she was gonna help
what me. What fines?
Like I have a lot of like court fines and stuff.
For what?
I still have like this credit card fraud charge. So like I'm going.
Wait! Oh no. Oh my, yo, this story gets worse and worse every 2 seconds. He's a criminal. This should have been in criminal fucking court. Why the fuck are we at the people's court?
You owe that.
Yes.
Right.
You're doing something terrible.
You're not going through shit.
Alright, so you have a credit card
you did that.
Charge of how much?
The total's probably like around like 3,000, 4,000.
Okay.
Bruh, he even said that he confided in her. Honestly, if a man sat there and confided in me about all of this, I would have ran for the fucking hills. I'd be like, get the fuck out. Okay? I have no idea what this girl was thinking. I mean, he's kind of cute, but not that cute. Definitely not that cute.
She was like saying like she'll help me and stuff. And then like, when I did have like, when she left to go to work that morning, like she didn't go anywhere else but to work. I know where she went. She went to work. You know, she left me in the house, and like I told her, I was gonna use the money, and I left the house.
Wait, you told her?
Yeah.
Who do you think you are?
Oh! Yo, just Milan, yo, I forgot how much I love this show.
Yo, I'm taking your money.
Like, what the fuck? Listen, Brad. Like, oh my God. Oh my God. She should have called the authorities. Like, no. Like, bitch, what?
What did she say that I'll led you to believe that you could take the money?
She said, I'll give you money to help you.
Okay.
I didn't take all of the money. Like, I only took, like, what, like, she gave me.
Hand you money?
Exactly.
Oh.
So that means you stole it.
The money that was in there.
You stole it.
Yeah.
Did you leave anything?
You stole it.
You took it all.
I didn't take it all. Whatever I took, I gave to the police. You know, like, when the police came to my house.
How much did you take?
Wait, what?
I guess it was like 1,700, 1,800.
Now, the really crazy thing about these court shows is a lot of them are real, but a lot of them are fake, okay? And the ones that are real, like I know Judge Mathis is real. Definitely divorce court is fake. This one, I believe, is real as well. And they actually do take real cases that are like, you know, pending in civil court. And then they bring them to TV. And usually the settlements are paid by the TV shows, if you guys did not know. This is wild because like, I don't know why this didn't go to criminal court. Like, he should be in jail right now. Like, jail before he does this shit to somebody else.
It just starts with, XO, please don't do this to me, giving you one more chance.
That's when I realized that he was gone and everything.
Okay, but the very first thing you say is, hey, don't do this to me?
Right.
Yeah.
How's he gonna know what you're saying if you're wrong? Like, how?
I knew he just ran off with the money.
Right, because you come home and the money's gone.
Yeah.
Why did you even look for the money?
Right.
Because I saw that the money was gone.
Oh, wait, how did you see the money was gone?
Because I had it in a corner of my room in a little container, and it was opened and just empty.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I pray that when I have a child, she does not do anything stupid like this. This is the most ridiculous shit I ever heard in my entire life.
He just kept saying that he would be back with it, that he was coming back, just everything that the technician
would
say, that he was going to come back even later with it.
Where?
Southbound at Brandon. You say,
where do you think he's about to bring it back for?
My money. And he says, Taya, please, I have to pay a fine for gun charge or was going to go to jail for a long time. Please, Taya, I will give it all back. I promise. I swear on everything I love. I wouldn't do you like that. I want to make babies with you, babes.
This is pathetic. Gun charge, fraud charge, bumbity bumbity bum bum bum. You see, this is what I mean. They really don't treat the preference any better.
You had his mom's phone number?
I went to his mother's house.
You knew where his mother lived?
Yeah.
Okay.
And this relationship advanced. In 3 weeks, you got his mom number? That's too much. In 3 weeks?
Taya, please, baby, please. I really love you.
The petty. This is so pathetic. You ever come across any man that's like this, just run, okay? He steals your money, report it, okay? Don't be sitting there trying to get chances, do all this little goofy, just stop. You have to stand up for yourself. You have to put your foot down.
You just took everything I ever worked for, even after I told you how it happened before. Oh, this isn't your first time?
I had a situation with another ex.
Yeah, what was it? Tell us all about it.
Well, in that situation, he wanted to borrow some money and stuff like that I handed to him.
This girl just has a really serious self-esteem issue, I'm convinced. Why the fuck are you sitting here giving men money? When you're in a relationship, you do good things for your significant other. I buy my man things. We, you know, sometimes buy each other things, bring each other places, go on trips. That's mutual, okay? But when it's like you're the one giving them money, they're not giving the money back when they say they're gonna give it back, when they're sitting here skipping out on you with your money that you didn't know was taken in the first place, when they're sitting here unloading their problems onto you and basically guilt tripping you into giving them money, this, that, and the third, that's a pattern that you have to recognize. And you cannot be giving money to these people when you only known them for 3 fucking weeks. If I was the judge, I would have been like, all right, case adjourned, because you clearly don't give a fuck about your money. You clearly just like giving these men money for whatever goddamn reason. Like, in all seriousness, I really feel like she has a serious issue in terms of like insecurity.
I can come back later, babe. I can't come now. I'm far. Yeah, it's inconvenient for me to come back and return the money I stole.
Oh my god, like, yo. The fact that he's even replying to the messages, like, y'all, he's not even a good criminal. He's not even a good scammer. Like, listen, if you gonna run game, if you gonna scam, if you gonna steal, you gonna do all that goofy shit, you can't be sitting here texting back and forth, so I love you, I wanna make babies, you do life away. Like, aren't you on child support? What the fuck you trying to do babies for? Like, what you trying to make babies with the girl for?
You are talking like a 12-year-old, not a woman who's alone on her own.
Seriously.
Who's saved up enough, you know, a sizable amount of money.
Right.
All right? Don't be stupid. How am I supposed to trust you? You always did. I need you to come back with my money. I need it back. I cannot help you like this. You didn't even tell me about your gun charge, and you used me to help fix it? A gun charge? Oh, tell me about the gun charge.
Right.
That was just a thing that I just said to her. Like, I just said it to her.
Oh, you don't really have a gun charge?
No.
You have the credit card fraud charge.
Yeah.
Nah, bruh. Like, we need to put this man on the America's Avoid list. Like, avoid dating blog form or something. This is fucking horrible. Who lies about a charge? Like, and you a wankster?
You say you a gangster, but you never. Nah, and you say you a gangster, but you never.
I'm trying to save the little bit of monetization I may get from this video, because there's a lot of words that's already been said that's probably already gonna get me demonetized. But yeah, you a wankster.
I'll hit you back in a few, okay? You this better be back. I really cannot believe you did this. I promise. This is my worst fear, and you did it. You know, there's no reason for you to be afraid of this.
Yeah.
The rest of us aren't afraid that's going to happen. You know why? Because we all kept $3,000 in front of a guy we met on Tinder 3 weeks ago and leave him alone with our $3,000 that we just counted in a cookie jar.
Chad, she had to tweak like that, but for real, like, are you dumb? I don't know if she understands the gravity of what she did, and chances are she probably still gonna go back and mess around with this man. Y'all, I really can't.
You just need to have all those brain cells in your head, hold hands. Oh. Okay.
Oh,
Child. This is me as a judge.
I didn't take her money. Like, I gave whatever I took from to the police. You know what I mean? Like, well, whatever I had.
How did the police catch up with you?
I'm sorry. I didn't take her money. I gave whatever I took to the police. Am I the only one that didn't catch that? Am I the only one that didn't catch the whole story in the beginning? Am I the only one not understanding that this man is full of shit? Y'all, trust me. Men like this are last cause, okay? Our last cause. I understand he's young. I understand she's young. And people can change. But these type of behaviors usually don't.
And I said I did not steal it. She gave it to me and I left.
Yeah, but and you know that's not true.
Exactly.
We just read the text together, so you're a liar.
Right.
You lied to the police about that because I just read you your texts.
Yeah.
And she already knew what I was going to use it for. And then when she finally realized, like, her mom was going to start tweaking, that's when she was like, I'm sorry.
He did not just say that shit in court.
I can see that she's freaking out the minute she came home and saw what you did. And she's begging you to find it within your heart to not be a jerk. And you're saying ridiculous things to her like, I want to make babies with you. Like, that's going to brush her off. Do you know how insulting that is?
To be honest, like, this is so horrible. I'm happy that she's still being empathetic to the fact that she got her money stolen. And I'm just really, really annoyed by his behavior and the fact that he's not understanding that he's digging himself into a deeper hole. Not only did you tell the story that reflected that you stole the money, but the text messages also reflect that you stole the money. She said you stole the money. And technically, in many different ways, you say that you took the money without her technically giving it to you physically. Therefore, you's a thief and you's a liar and you should be in jail. Oh my lord, like any girl that comes across him, y'all better run and y'all better hide because chances are he's gonna do this again.
Because you acted like a bimbo and it has nothing to do with Tinder. You were acting like a dummy, okay? Yeah. I'm not talking about how you meet guys or what you choose to do. You be you, girl, okay? Be you with connected brain cells.
No, dead ass.
You don't count money for some guy you knew 2 weeks. Are you crazy?
The thing is, I feel like both of them are really not taking this seriously. Like, the mom and her are kikiing in the corner, and every single time, you know, she actually, like, puts her in her place, they go back to being serious, and she's trying to look sad again. Like, bitch, niggas is trying to cap for you. Niggas is trying to actually feel bad for you, and you sitting here, ha, I understand. Yeah, I get it now. No, you don't. Because you think this is funny. And you're going to be in the same boat again. Because the second time you're going through this, I'm sure it's going to be a third, fourth, fifth, sixth, eighth, 25th time. And then he's sitting there with a smirk. Like, he's so damn adorable. Like, he can get any bitch he want and do this again. Which I'm sure he can. Because there's too many girls out here who are willing to give their money to men without any type of common sense as to what that will do, as to any common sense as to what they will do with the money, as to any common sense as to what that represents to a nigga. I've never in my life would have thought I see the day where somebody would be on court for some shit like this regarding a Tinder date, like taking a money like this. This is just dumb.
According to you, you talked to him about a payment plan. Was that on the phone or by text?
That was on the phone and everything like that. That's not written down anywhere.
How many times have you been convicted?
Probably like 3 times.
What were the others?
Burglary and burglary.
It's consistent! Like, come on! And I'm sure she knew about that shit. You gonna let this man stay in your fucking house. You see, this is the type of dumb shit that I fucking can't know. I cannot feel bad for this girl. No, I can't. Like, girl, wait.
She knows that, though, from, like, where I live at and, like, how
I'm sorry.
Like
how
that.
Dare you?
She does.
How dare you suggest that where you live means you're going to be
right.
A criminal? How dare you?
It's not
insult the people of your community in that fashion.
Right. I'm really happy she stopped him right there because I already know that shit was not going to go well. First of all, y'all, ladies, gentlemen, always run a hoe fax, okay? A hoe fax consists of A, Googling the full name, B, finding out about that person in the neighborhood, and C, finding out anything you can that just don't seem right, okay? I'm talking about STDs, I'm talking about tax records, I'm talking about Carly. I'm not playing with y'all. Like, y'all might be laughing, but I'm dead ass. You better pay for that little Ben Verify fucking account and literally start Googling niggas, start Googling their neighbors, start Googling their aunts, uncles, brothers, because you never know what will pop up. Like, I literally have had friends literally go on dates with people that have been, like, literally sex offenders. Like, I'm not joking. Like, it's a very serious situation.
I wanted to meet up with him. Anything after that was just trying to...
Did you go over there?
I think I did, yeah.
What'd you do?
I was trying to talk to him.
And fuck him. Get back together?
No. I'm just trying to talk to him about the money.
Fuck him.
That's it.
What did I say? What did I say? After that bullshit, they was gonna fuck around and fuck. Yo, listen, give me a shout. Give me a shout. Oh my god.
Yeah, October, that's when I was, like, giving her weed and stuff.
Tell me about the weed.
For the payments. Like, for the payments and stuff, like, I didn't really have the money. So, like, I smoke a lot of
weed. Wait, what payments? If according to you, you gave back all the money, why would there be payments?
Exactly.
Right, so why are you paying her with weed?
That's how I was thinking of it, but I'm like, all right, like, she's still tripping. You know what I'm saying?
The language in the courtroom, like, you have no respect for the judge or the courtroom with this language, and I know you've been there numerous of times. Like, please stop it. Like, oh my god. This is embarrassing for the both of them. Like, honestly, she should have just kept her mouth shut. The fact that even came up in court that they were fucking after all of this is horrible. Like, at this point, no one's going to feel bad for you. I cannot feel bad for anyone.
I was trying to keep up a communication line.
I think you're saying that now because your mother's in the room and America's watching. I'm still aghast that your mom is smiling. You need to look deep within your soul
yep.
and figure out why you don't like you.
Yup.
Why you don't think you're worth more. Why you don't think you are worthy of loyalty.
Yup.
A good person who isn't snowing you.
Yup.
Why? What happened in your life that would make you think that you, the only way you can keep a man is if you do these things that you're doing. It's crazy.
Thank you, Judge Milan. Thank you. Hands down, one of my favorite judges, okay? She literally just took the words right out of my mouth. Like, this is definitely a very serious issue that she's battling internally because ain't no one in a right mind can get scammed like this and still deal with the scammer who hasn't paid them back.
Did he ever pay you anything?
He paid me $1,300 from the cops of what the money that I assumed
right, did he ever pay you anything after
that? Oh, the payment plans didn't work out, no. That's him in my bedroom with the money that he was playing with like a toy.
That you let him play with like a toy?
Yeah.
She let the man play with the money. All right, you know what? I'm done. I'm physically ill. You let him take the money and play with it? So, no. Let me get this straight. You met the man 3 weeks ago. You counted all the money that you had in front of him and left him alone with the money after you let him take pictures with the money and flex with the money that was yours and not his. You know that he had pending charges and he technically was short on cash, in which you never gave him the money, but some way, somehow, he ended up dashing with the money while you were gone. I really hope that she doesn't get the money. Because why, this right here is what would have made me really be like, you ain't getting shit, because why are you letting him flex with it?
Wads of fake $100 bills, just okay, the flashy pictures.
Okay, he's your dope supplier.
Yeah.
Right, so, okay, so how do you know they're fake? God. Maybe they're real.
Oh no, they were fake, they had Chinese pink lettering on them.
Okay.
This is so pathetic. See, this is why I be telling y'all, like, everything that I be saying in my videos, they're coming into fruition. I'm telling y'all, a lot of these men and a lot of these women you be seeing on Instagram and on social media flexing all this money and flexing all this wealth or whatever, a lot of it is from DHgate and Amazon, okay? The money is phony. The possessions ain't real, okay? It's fake as fuck and they trying to sell y'all a dream that is not existent.
I find that you are a liar and a thief, and I'm ordering you to pay her back $1,400. I gotta tell you, it kills me because what I would like to do is fine you $1,400 for stupidity.
Ooh.
But I can't because all I've gotta do is look at this and say, where did that money belong? And the money belongs with you. If you want any hope for you,
right.
You've gotta make sure that you figure out who you're gonna date and trust.
Yep.
Got it? Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Verdict for the plaintiff.
That's it for this case. If you guys want to watch the entire thing, I will have it linked down below. I had to cut a lot of it out due to copyright purposes. And to be honest, this had to be the most ridiculous drop ever seen on a court show. Like, I really can't feel that bad for her. This is the second time she did it. The man's a criminal. This man was very, very open about his criminal past. And then on top of that, after he stole the money from you, you continue to fuck him. For why? For what? And I'm very, very aware that, you know, when people have low self-esteem or whatever the case may be, it is very hard to come out of that. But certain things should be legitimate common sense. If someone scams you, you don't don't go fucking with them again. Like, this is just beyond me. Comment down below what you think about this video. And also, send me some more very interesting court cases you would like me to react to, because these shits are so fucking hilarious. One of my favorite court shows happens to be Paternity Court, followed by the Judge Mathis Show. What are your favorite court shows? Make sure you comment down below. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe. Do all that. Get your merchandise. Peep the description box. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye!